Hi, my name is Adhika Karsh. I'm from Chanakya National University and presently I'm an intern at LexClick. In this video, we're going to talk about animal rights laws in India. What we need to understand is the fact that animal rights have been subdued for a very long time. And it's only recently that many cases, many case laws, landmark judgments have actually pushed for more strict rules in the realm of animal rights. Now, from where it all stems out is the Indian Constitution, because in Indian Constitution Part 4, we are given the fundamental duties, and the fundamental duties, Article 51A, says that it shall be the duty of every citizen of India to protect and improve their natural environment, including forests, lakes, rivers and wildlife, to have compassion for living creatures. And in the case of State of Gujarat versus Mirzapur Moti Qureshi Kasab Jamaat, the Honorable Supreme Court defined the term compassion as compassion under Article 51AG as an emotion of soft feeling that arises out of sympathy, love and kindness. Now we need to understand that it is not only a fundamental right, but it is also given under DPSPs, where Article 48 and 48A provides that the state shall endeavor to organize animal husbandry and to safeguard and protect the wildlife of the country. So it's not only the duty of every citizen of India to abide by the rules of respecting every living creature, but it's also the duty of the government to make laws in that direction. In the case of Animal Welfare Board of India versus A. Nagaraja, Supreme Court gave a wider meaning to the term life under Article 21 and also included the rights of animals and the fair treatment of animals in the definition of life. Now, the most stringent rule for animal rights in India is the Prevention of Cruelty Act 1960. It came as a replacement for Prevention of Cruelty Act of Animal Cruelty. Cruelty to animals, 1860. Now this act was provided for the establishment for a welfare board, for animal welfare board, which was supposed to act under this central government for the purpose of animal welfare, and it worked hand in hand with the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy. Now this act confers two sections, Section 3 and Section 1. In Section 3, it tells that the owner of the animals should treat them fairly and should take reasonable care of all the animals under their care. And Section 11 of the Act states that it is one of 11 is a very important section in the Act, because it specifies the activities or actions that will be regarded as cruelty against the animals. Now the basic essence of the entire act is given in Section 3 and Section 11. That is because these sections are read with Article 51AG of the Indian Constitution, and it only confers duties and responsibilities and the obligations that human beings and the owners of animals have towards these animals. And section 3, 11, subsection 1, A and O and other related provisions have to be understood along with Article 51A G of the Constitution. Now, it also has penalties that if a person mistreats and commits cruelty against an animal, what will be the punishments and how much fine do they have to give and all of that. Now, we need to understand the judicial approach of all of this. It was in a very landmark case, Karnal Singh and others versus State of Haryana, where we realize and where the Supreme Court gives a stand and makes an extremely progressive change in the jurisprudence of animal rights and the law regarding it, where it says that it is within the purview of the Indian Constitution that animal rights should be taken care of, and there should be more stringent laws to take care of it, And the Justice Rajiv Sharma in this judgment clearly stated the entire animal kingdom, including avian and aquatic, are declared as legal entity having a distinct persona with corresponding rights, duties and liabilities of a living person. All the citizens throughout the state of Haryana are hereby declared persons in loco parentis as the human face for welfare / protection of animals. So we understand that in the recent years we have seen many cases and many laws, and it's something that we as a citizen of India and as a human being need to understand that the rights of animals and every other living thing also comes under the purview of mankind, and something that should be humanly followed by every citizen in or outside India. And we need to understand that a person, if a person treats an animal unfairly and in an inhumane manner, then that person is going to be held liable by the laws of India. Thank you.